Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
This is our little interview with Arpaio. It's about 8 minutes long. We'll play part of it now and go to break and play the rest when we come back. Then we have their head investigator in a longer interview. And he brought up the fact that in 50 years, this is the worst censorship he's ever seen of what he's actually found and put out. And he also got into the fact, this is breaking, that regardless of what the legislature does with their bill to demand the original real birth certificate with proof, they're going to go ahead with their investigation. So his investigation is going to continue regardless of what the state does there and more. Here is that interview that Patrick Henningsen and Rob Jacobson conducted yesterday at the sheriff's office in Maricopa County, Arizona. Here it is, Infowars.com exclusive.
What's the significance of this bill today, this legislation that's been introduced this week?
Well, I think it's important. It's only common sense. Using a law to pursue, to make sure the person that is running is who that person is. I don't think it's asking too much. I believe that our investigation probably substantiates the need for this. When you look at the evidence that we have accrued in the last 6 months with our cold case posse, anybody with common sense looking at those two documents that we feel are forged would say, wait a minute, you know, we better get another system going to make sure this doesn't happen again. So it's only common sense, but there's a lot of politics involved. People don't want to even talk about it. You can see there's not many people that showed up here. Everybody wants to ignore this subject. Most of the questions in that press conference on March 1 wasn't about the evidence. They didn't want to talk about that. It's all, this has been already done. You know, this is old stuff. Why don't they talk about the evidence? Nobody's talking about the evidence, which is very interesting. And there seems to be a national blackout on this. I mean, you know, whatever I do, I make national news. When I put people in pink underwear, I always make national news. But this one, they don't want to talk to the sheriff.
How's your response been from your constituents in general about those who know about this effort?
Well, quite frankly, I didn't know how it would work, whether they would be against me, since everybody else seems to avoid the issue. But it hasn't been as bad as I thought. I don't get many negatives other than these Mickey Mouse threats and garbage through blogs. But the people that I meet, and I meet every day, I'm giving speeches. Hundreds of people a day come up for my picture and so on. But they never say anything bad about what I'm doing on the Obama thing. In fact, a lot of them like what I'm doing. So politically, it hasn't hurt me, but it doesn't matter because I would have done it anyway. But I'm a little surprised at the support on this issue, those that are willing to talk about it. Now, all the majority of politicians don't even want to talk about it, Republicans and Democrats. It's like the plague to talk about this. I've never seen anything like this, and I've been a top federal law enforcement official for years and years. And I knew about the Watergate, and I've been through it all. But I never seen this situation.
What is that?
Censored.
Has Arizona got a higher standard of vetting? Is it, that's what's really being shown here? Is Arizona's?
That's what we'd like.
They've stepped up to, that's what they example, want. To the other
Yeah, that's
states.
What they want. And I think that what I came up with probably is it really reiterates the need for this. It just happens to be in Arizona. And the Tea Party came to me and asked me to look into it. And I gave it to my volunteer posse made up of ex-cops and attorneys at no cost to the taxpayers, and they report to me. I have 3,000 posses, and I happen to have a cold case posse, and I told them to look into it. I mean, what's the big deal? And when they did, they did a good job in coming up with a lot of evidence. So what should I do? Dump it in a wastebasket and forget it? It's incumbent on me when I find suspicious activity, if I can't handle it, give it to other authorities that can, if they will, and not drop it. So I'm not dropping this. I'm going to keep moving forward.
All right, let me stop you right there. We're going to come back and play the rest of this. But here's the issue. We have inside sources inside the sheriff's department that have confirmed that Arpaio is fearing for his life from Obama, and that Arpaio has a lot more information than he's even released. The fact that there's probable cause and the birth certificate is clearly fake. No kidding. It's a fake typewriter computer font, because with a real typewriter, every strike is original, even of the same letter, because it splats. You hit the button with different force, it hits the ribbon. All that's one issue. Arpaio has even more. And we can confirm what our other source inside the department said, because we have Jerome Corsi, who's been told by the sheriff's department that they've gotten more security because they're worried about the White House coming after them, you name it. And so this is big news. We're going to come back with the rest of the interview straight ahead. Stay with us.
Everything we said came true. Everything we've done has been right.
All right, now, tomorrow, either on the radio or on the nightly news, we've got 30 minutes with Zolo, the chief investigator, with new forensic info. That's the real meat of this interview. And then we've also got Jerome Corsi there. But we'll hear part of it on the radio tomorrow, but undoubtedly all of it, unedited, just the whole thing, we're going to put it up on the nightly news. David Icke tonight, 7 o'clock. Let's go to the rest of this piece with Arpaio there in Phoenix.
And not drop it. So I'm not dropping this. I'm going to keep moving forward.
How good is this team you've assembled, in your opinion?
Well, they're ex-cops. Mike has done a great job on this, living this for 24 hours a day. And does just as good if he was full-time. But he's an ex-cop. He just doesn't get paid. But he has the authority under me, under the Constitution. I can swear in. Private citizens called the posse, and they have the same coverage as a regular deputy. They just don't get paid. So isn't this great? So I can't get all the public to say you're wasting taxpayers' money. I decided to do this right off the bat because the media would be after me. Why are you wasting taxpayers' money? Although right now, at this point of time, I could use regular deputies. We're talking about two possible fraud and forgery cases.
If the legislation gets killed for whatever reason this week, are you still going to continue with your efforts? And what do you see? Where is it going next? Next step, for instance, on a federal level or so forth?
Oh, we're not stopping. Whether it's passed or not passed, we're going to continue doing our job. This would just help us a little. Actually, this was passed last year. The governor vetoed this.
Okay.
So I don't understand, and they made it a little milder this time around, so I don't understand why it can't be passed again. But nobody wants to talk about it, probably because I stuck my nose in it, and I'm kind of coming up with evidence that there's something wrong. You'd think that would make everybody want to do something about it. But everybody wants to keep it, don't talk about it. Democrats, Republicans, you name it. So what is this, a political year? That everybody's afraid to talk about it, or they don't want nothing done about it? They don't want to face this issue? That's sad.
Do you think America asks a lot of the countries around the world to uphold a certain standard of democracy and transparency in their affairs? How important is it for us to have that level of transparency and accountability and integrity here at home? Is that what this represents?
I think it's very important. Now, I'm just looking at it as a law enforcement guy. I'm looking at two crimes. I'm not accusing the president of violating any law. What we're looking at is two possible forged government documents. If it was you or anybody else, everybody would be saying, how come you're not arresting this guy? How come you're not doing it? Just because it's the president? It's nobody wants to touch it? That's sad. So, as I say, we're not accusing the president, but we sure know somebody's responsible for that selected service form and for the birth certificate that they went public and showed. What confuses me is the amateur type of operations they were performing. When you look at the birth certificate, that's sort of amateur. And yet everybody says that that's a legitimate birth certificate. Well, I'll tell you how to solve this. And day one, when I launch this operation, all I say is, show me the microfiche. Mm-hmm. Show the microfiche, and it's all over.
Yeah.
Where's the microfiche in the hospital? Come on. We got two twins born at the same time. So just show us the microfiche. Another thing that's suspicious, as I have, sometimes I have a conspiracy theory, is the fact we went to the archives in Washington and looked at all the immigration forms up to August 1, 1961, and then August 7th, but there's a whole week missing when he was born. Now, is that another coincidence? I can go on and on and on, and yet nobody wants to talk about it.
Well, Chair Carr, thank you very much.
Pretty powerful. And the Kenyan records are missing too. Stolen. Ask yourselves, what are you doing in this time of great challenge? What are you doing to unlock minds?